This is the iStorage datAshur PRO+C, so it's USB-C, and it's a hardware-encrypted flash drive that requires a pin to unlock. It's designed if you need some serious data security, and I'd say the cool thing is that it doesn't rely on software. I've been testing it for a good while for basic tasks, and there isn't a huge amount to say, and that's actually kind of the point. So let's talk about it. To start with what it is and the build quality, this is a hardware-encrypted USB-C flash drive. It comes with an adapter included for USB-A. It has a built-in keypad for pin entry to actually unlock the device so you can access your files, and it's available between 32GB and 512GB. IP68 rated, so it's waterproof and dustproof. And if you're technical on the security side of things, it's got AES-XTS 256-bit encryption, which is quite secure with many security features that we'll cover later with pending FIPS 140S certification. It's got an aluminum shell. It feels pretty solid. It comes with this cover, which is pretty cool, so you can protect it and it looks very nice. My one complaint is actually with the adapter. You see, if you plug this in and then you try to put the case on, doesn't fit. What this means is there's actually no loop or anything on the adapter, so you need to keep this safe and not lose it, which I would probably do, to be honest, knowing me. So you see it's a pin, and you might be wondering what it's like to set up. And to be honest, it was a bit of a process for me. It took me like 5 to 10 minutes to get this timing right. And yes, there is timing involved. This isn't super intuitive when I was reading the instructions. So let me show you how I mean and how you can do this via a demo that I wish I had when I received the device.
So first you press the key button once and all LEDs should switch on, solid red and blinking green. Then you press it twice, the key button, and they should all switch to a blinking blue. You enter your new user pin, and then you press the key button twice, and it's going to switch to a blinking green LED. And this is all time-based. Re-enter that new pin to confirm it, and then press the key button twice again, and then a solid red LED will switch to a solid green one to show that it's created and unlocked. And then you're good there. To unlock it, you press the key button once, and the red LED will blink, and then you enter your user pin, and then press the key button once, and it'll switch to a solid green to show you that it's unlocked. And you can actually unlock it without it needing to be plugged into a device if the battery inside is charged up. Yes, there is a small rechargeable battery in there.
To be honest, I think it could be a bit more intuitive, but once it's set up, it's set up. And once you get the hang of it, it's not a huge deal, but yeah, I did need the manual next to me the whole time setting it up. Now, in fairness, the reason it's designed this way is there is no software dependency. There are no drivers, no apps. It kind of just works everywhere. This is compatible on all operating systems, at least desktop, pretty easily, Windows, Mac, Linux. This is its own encryption on its own device. You don't need to install Veracrypt. You can use it on anybody's device. You can take it to your friend's house. They don't need any software. You don't need to touch their device. You just plug it in, put in your pin, plug it in, put in your pin. How do I make this rhyme? Oh, I got it. Okay, plug it in, put in the pin, and then give a nice grin. That is so bad. So I already gave you a little bit of a preview of what that looks like, but in terms of daily use, there is no lock button. There's a lock indicator there, but all you need to do is you just unplug it when you're done. It auto locks on removal. Of course, don't do this while you're transferring a file or anything like this, but yeah, you just unplug it. In terms of performance, it's not the fastest drive I've ever seen in my life. It's up to 310 megabits per second, and the write, I think, is like around 250. In real use, it's fast enough. I wouldn't use this to like edit videos off of or anything. I don't think that's the use case, but if you have sensitive documents, especially in something like the corporate environment, small business, I think it makes sense. Now, there was one hiccup that caught me off guard. I'm used to working with video files that are pretty massive, so naturally I tried transferring one of our video projects onto this drive, and I very quickly hit that old classic, you can't copy files larger than 4 GB error. This is because it comes formatted with FAT32, which is good for compatibility, but not so great for flexibility with larger files. So yes, I was wondering, and you should know, you can reformat the drive to exFAT or NTFS. So that is kind of a pro tip I have for a lot of you. Probably use exFAT, especially if you need something larger than 4 GB per file. And if you're wondering how, just unlock the drive and you can actually format it like any other USB drive through your OS. Like I said earlier, the encryption here happens on the hardware level, so you can reformat this without impacting your security here. So who's this for? People who have sensitive needs for their files, if you're in the medical profession, legal, financial, journalism, anything like this, I think that's where there's a pretty clear, obvious reason to use this. Also, if you need any compliance, so those certifications I talked about earlier might not super matter for a regular person, but if you're a business and you're able to say, hey, we had the certification and we lost our files and here's why, you know that they're still safe, that can be helpful as well. It's also cool there's no software dependency. So if you're having to juggle between multiple devices and you want flexibility across maybe even new people, that is a plus here. And also, if you want to travel with sensitive information, I think this is a really good way to do it. And speaking of travel, just heads up, there is an interesting feature. There's a self-destruct pin that you can set. So if you ever need an emergency wipe of the drive, just enter that pin, and it's kind of like a distress pin in a way, and then it'll make the data irrecoverable. So who's this drive not for? I would say it's overall actually kind of a niche product. I think that if you're just looking for a typical fast flash drive that you're using for non-sensitive things, this isn't it. It's not for you if you prefer software encryption for whatever reason. I'm sure you can combine encryption via software and this hardware, but I'm not sure why you would do that. I'd also say one general criticism, and maybe someone this won't speak to, is someone who believes fully in open hardware. Most of this hardware, if not all of it, is proprietary. And of course, I really have to leave it out there. This is not for you if you're on a tight budget, because these things are actually not that cheap, and you can get flash drives for much cheaper. So the reality is, once this is set up, it is just a flash drive that requires a pin, and that's it. You're actually getting some top tier security for a very minimal, easy product, and that's kind of exactly what it should be. So they're not trying to do anything fancy, they're not splitting the atom. It encrypts your data at the hardware level, requires physical access and a pin to unlock, and it works everywhere without software. It's a cool product, haven't touched something like this before, and I'm sure it speaks to someone out there. And that's actually my takeaway. I think the best security device is the one you're actually going to use consistently. So if that's VeraCrypt and using the flash drive you already own, you should do that. And if you find that clunky and you want something that makes it simple and deals with it for you, then this might be actually what gets you to secure your files a little bit better. Thank you for watching, and if you enjoy these reviews and the other content that we have on Techlore, you can support us down below on Patreon and also via our other support methods. Everything is very appreciated, and it keeps this content free for all of you. So thank you all for making that possible. And check out this video on the screen where I cover some of the daily security tools that I use on a daily basis. And that is for real, for real. Those are things I use every day, and I think everything in it I still use to this day. So check that out, and I'll see you guys next time.